On behalf of Mendeor GK and PrepQ, I welcome you to our daily current affairs session. And as you already know, in these sessions, we discuss exam-oriented questions, questions that can appear in any government exam or any MBA entrance exams where current affairs might be asked. So generally, we focus and we target exams like the SSC or the IBPS or the RRB, that is Railway Recruitment Board exam, or even the LIC exam, if you're talking of government exams. And when we speak about MBA entrance exams, these questions are similar to questions that appear in SNAP or that might appear in CMAT or even the TISNET conducted by the Tata Institute of Social Sciences. So the date today is 6th July 2019, and here is the first question for the day. On which day World Sports Journalist Day is observed? So the correct answer to this question is 2nd of July, and it was established by the International Sports and Press Association, AIPS, which is also known as Association Internationale de la Presse Sportive, in 1994, and it was established to mark the 70th anniversary of its foundation. So AIPS was basically founded on 1924, 2nd July, during the Summer Olympics in Paris. Sports journalists from all over the world are united by AIPS. In India, the Sports Federation is named as Sports Journalist Federation of India, SJFI, that was set up in 1976. Next question. Who launched Dr. Krishna's book, Dr. Krishna Saxena's book, Whispers of Time, in New Delhi? The correct answer is Smriti Irani. And you might be aware that she is also, that is Smriti Irani is also the Minister of Women and Child Development. So she launched the book at the India International Center in New Delhi. The book was published by Prabhat Prakashan, and the book speaks about the life and experiences of Dr. Krishna Saxena. Next question. Karnam Sekar was appointed as the new managing director and chief executive officer of which of the following banks? The correct answer is Indian Overseas Banks. So Indian Overseas Bank is a public sector bank based in Chennai, and the MD and CEO prior to Karnam Sekar was R. Subramanya Kumar. Karnam Sekar also served State Bank of India as the Deputy Managing Director and the Chief Credit Officer. IOB is a major public sector bank based in Chennai with about 3,400 branches. Next question. Dr. Jaya Arunachalam, veteran social activist, has passed away. Which state did she belong to? So, Dr. Jaya Arunachalam, the name is a giveaway. She belonged to Tamil Nadu. So, she was the founder of Working Women's Forum, WWF. And she was best known for her contribution through WWF, which she initiated in 1970. She has helped lakhs of women from underprivileged background to organize themselves towards becoming financially independent. Dr. Arunachalam was also awarded the Padma Shri in 1987. She also received the Jamnalal Bajaj Award in 2009 for her works towards the welfare of women and children. Next question. The Economic Survey 2019 has projected X percent in growth in 2019-20. What is the value of X? The value of X, that is the growth rate projected by Economic Survey, is 7%. The Economic Survey was tabled by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. And this survey has pegged a GDP growth rate of 7%, which has risen from 6.8%. And as you are already aware, the gross domestic product measures the value of economic activity within a country. And it is defined as the sum of market value or prices of all final goods and services produced in an economy during a period of time. It's one of the primary indicators used to gauge the health of a country's economy. And you might be aware that in terms of GDP, India is today the fifth ranked country. USA is the top country with around $21 trillion economy. China with $12 trillion. Japan around $5 trillion. Germany and United Kingdom. So India is the sixth largest economy currently. So this year it is expected that Indian economy might rise higher than UK's economy. Next question. The world-renowned Jagannath Yatra, Rath Yatra, has begun in which Indian state? It's a no-brainer. The correct answer is Odisha. So it began on 4 July 2019 in Odisha. And in this Yatra, Lord Jagannath, Lord Balabhadra and Devi Subhadra ride three giant, and they really are giant wooden chariots as they travel to the Gundicha temple. Next question. Which state's assembly has passed a bill proposing a hike in retirement age of vice chancellors of the state-owned universities? The correct answer is West Bengal. So the West Bengal has passed a bill which endorsed hiking the retirement age of vice chancellors from 65 years to 70 years. And this bill actually replaces an ordinance on the same matter. So many vice chancellors above 65 years can be very active and they contribute towards the development of universities. This was the statement of the State Education Department. And therefore, it was felt that raising the age of vice chancellors, retirement age of vice chancellors, could actually contribute towards the growth of education in the state. Next question. Which Indian scientist has been selected as co-investigator by NASA for its Punch mission? The correct answer is Deepankar Banerjee. He is a solar physicist from Indian Institute of Astrophysics. And he has been selected by National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, for the Punch mission. So what does Punch stands for? Punch stands for polarization, polarimeter to unify. It should not be polarization. It should be polarimeter to unify corona and heliosphere. And it is focused on understanding the transition of particles from sun's outer corona to the solar wind that fills the interplanetary space. Punch will consist of a constellation of four suitcase-sized microsatellites that will orbit the Earth in formation and study how the corona, which is the atmosphere of the sun, connects with the interplanetary median. This mission is expected to be launched in 2022. The mission will image and track the solar wind and also the coronal mass ejections, which are huge masses of plasma that get thrown out of the sun's atmosphere. Next question. Where was National Sailing Championship inaugurated? The correct answer is Hyderabad. And this was the 34th edition of national level sailing championship. It was inaugurated by Telangana Governor ESL Narasimhan. And the championship is held every year in the twin cities of Hyderabad and Secunderabad. Next question. Which nation has proposed to ban the return of extremists for 2 years? The correct answer to this question is Australia. So, as Australia prepares to repatriate some Islamic group supporters from West Asia, around 230 Australians earlier had flown to Syria and Iraq to fight with the extremist group since 2012. And therefore, the need to impose such a ban that was felt by Australia. So they have banned the return of extremists for 2 years. With this, we have arrived at the question for the day. The first question is, who has been appointed as the MD and CEO of Indian Overseas Bank? And the second, Which state has passed a bill proposing a hike in the retirement age? If you know the answers to both these questions, you can write them in the comment section given below. You can also provide your feedback regarding these sessions, because your feedback is what leads to development and changes to our daily sessions. If you are a CAT aspirant, you can log on to my prepq.com to access 3 wonderful courses on CAT. And if you want any career related guidance, you're free to talk to me on this number. WhatsApp me. That is all for today. Thank you very much.